Okay, good evening, everybody.
Good evening.
My name is Juan Felipe Solis.
I'm an architect.
I also an industrial designer, which I'm already giving classes in University of Ibagué in Colombia. I'm a specialist in sustainable design in architecture, and that's why I'm going to talk about the sustainability in buildings. It's really an issue that is going on from a lot of years, many years ago, but many architects didn't have realized that our buildings have this problem. It's incredible, and they didn't connect what's happening with the people inside of the buildings and with the environment that we have inside. Did you people know that buildings are make you sick?
Yes, we don't know,
but yeah, they are making us sick. And after seeing this picture, we see and how this start, my project start. This is one of our assistants in my university. She's having this huge lighting problem, reflection problem, in which she solved it, putting just a cardboard in the front in the most intuitive way. But this is not the way how people should work. People should work in better lighting and also ergonomic conditions. So that's why I decided to start working in this project. This project became this methodology. This is a little methodology in which I start using the latest technological developments and put it in just one single methodology. Where I started first in a collection of data, this is the collection of data, I use drone scanning just to try to track how the buildings geometry, all the building materials, the position and everything, just to have the exact data that I need to, after all, make an environmental analysis. Why they're having this environmental analysis? How, for example, the sun put, how the sun shine, for example, in some of different materials and how is the reflection on those different materials. Also, how those materials react with the sun and all with the air and everything. And also, after that, I use an inspiration, which I call that morphogenesis. What is morphogenesis? Morphogenesis is this kind of exercise in which is the start of the shape. And I use as an inspiration the human skin. The human skin, as you know, the human skin work for us as a protection. It's a skin from the sun, from the elements. So I decided to use this element as one of the main concepts for building my project. After that, I generate from computational design what's the main thing of this project. I develop an algorithm. This algorithm is based on having this information connected to this algorithm, and in order of those information, it will create an adaptable geometry. This adaptable geometry will use all the information that is taken from the sun, from the materials and everything, and will create a geometry, what we call a complex geometry. This complex geometry, after that, is created in digital fabrication. What is digital fabrication? We use digital fabrication just to replicate the things that normally people cannot do with their hands. They do it just because they have vectors and many things that have been inside of computers. And with laser cutters, 3D printers, we can do that. And the end of this exercise, that what is the result, is this. This is one of our simulations, what we have before. These are our assistants that we have over here with just the shine of the sun. And can you see their faces? The faces having a lot of shine in the sun. So they're having a lot of problems, health problems in their faces. And after that, after using this algorithm, I create this. This is a kind of skin. And this skin regulates all the light that happening in the space. In this thing, we have this simulation where we have 700 luxes. And we are able to stabilize this information up to 100 luxes, which are the standard illuminations that we have for our work, for work spaces. And this is what is done in the real life. So we fabricate this, we try this in the real life, and after that, it works. So it was a really good exercise when we asked to our assistants how they feel after this exercise. And they were like, now I can see. Because, yeah, they had a lot of health eye problems. So that's what I did. Well, if any of you, well, this is the exercise from the outside. And as you can see, they have different kind of holes or perforations, and that's because the different kind of reflection they're having in this inside of the building is different in every part of the facade. So in that moment, the element has been regulate the sun that came inside of all the working spaces. And well, if you want to see a little bit of this in a 360 view, well, you can scan the 3D, the QR code, and you can see it, well, from the inside. Thank you very much. Thank you.